plant viruses. Now we will see different types of plant viruses. First, a general introduction about plant viruses and the different types of plant viruses which are responsible for the plant diseases. Now we will see one by one. My name is N.H. Shankar Reddy and I am doing PhD plant pathology in Annamalai University. So entering into the virus, definition of virus is a poison. It is a Latin word which means poison or venom. It is a Latin word, virus is the Latin word which means poison or venom, which is a virus is a submicroscopic mesobiotic infectious organism. It contains nucleoprotein, which contains nucleic acid and protein. So this word was given by F.C. Bowden and N.W. Pyrie. They called virus is a nucleoprotein, which means it contains nucleic acid and protein code. That's why it's called as nucleoprotein. Nucleic acid and the protein code, the combination of nucleic acid and protein code the virus contains. They are strictly obligate parasite. All viruses are strictly obligate parasites. Obligate parasite means they can't be cultured in a artificial nutrient medium. That's why it's called as obligate parasites. They only multiply in a living cells. Here the viruses contains either DNA or RNA, but not both. Here virus contains any one type of genetic material only. It may be RNA or it may be DNA, but not both. It contains only one type of genetic material. But most of the plant pathogenic virus contains RNA as genetic material. So here the term virus was coined by Bizernik. He is the scientist Bizernik. He is also considered as father of plant virology. And the term virus was also coined by Bizernik while working with tobacco mosaic virus. So coming to the properties of plant viruses. So most of the plant pathogenic viruses contains RNA as genetic material. As I said in a previous slide, it contains any one type of genetic material, that may be DNA or RNA. But most of the plant pathogenic viruses contains RNA as genetic material. Here virus does not contain any cell wall, but the protein coat which acts like a protective layer or cell wall like, because it protects the nucleic acid. Whereas the nucleic acid is the main infectious material, so this protein coat act as a protective layer or a cell wall like structure, but it contains no true cell wall. Okay, so mainly viruses contains two compounds or components, that is nucleic acid and protein coat. Here the nucleic acid is the infectious material, protein coat only protects nucleic acid which is present inside. But protein coat has no role of disease spread or transmission, whereas nucleic acid plays a major role. Here viruses produce different types of symptoms like maybe mosaic or leaf curl, crinkling, stunting, chlorosis, wind clearing, wind bending, and different types of symptoms which is produced by the viruses. But the majorly whatever the symptom is, yellowing can be the most observed symptom that can be produced by the viruses. What will happen after virus infection? The chlorophyll content can be reduced. Due to the reduction of chlorophyll content, what will happen? The green color leaves turned into yellow color. That is the most important symptom. Whatever the symptom is, yellowing can be mostly observed. So here the thing is, the virus can move from one cell to another cell through plasmodesmata. Actually here, normally plasmodesmata is smaller than that of virus. But how this virus can move through plasmodesmata? It produces a movement protein. So due to the production of a movement protein, it can mediate the transmission. It can mediate the movement through plasmodesmata. So virus moves from one cell to another cell through plasmodesmata. Viruses come with variety of shapes, that is a rod shape, isometric or baseliform in shape. So usually I have given the example, that is a rigid rod shape, that is tobacco mosaic virus and the tobacco rattle viruses that are comes under rod shape. Among that rod shape are two types, that is flexuous rod and filamentous rod. Examples are given here, that is flexuous rod is potato virus X and filamentous rod is a rice grassy stunt virus. So coming to isometric rice tuberous spherical form virus, and cucumber mosaic virus that comes in rhizometric viruses, and basiliform, rice tumor basiliform virus, and banana streak viruses are comes under the shapes of basiliform viruses. On the right side, they have given the diagrammatic representation, and the few are seen in a rod shape, that is tobacco mosaic virus, and few are no spherical shape, that is herpavirus. Few are, you know, you can see here tadpole shape, that is a bacteriophage, or some of the T4 even bacteriophages, and you know it is also look like some of the spherical little bit like that, and different types of viruses possess different types of shapes. So there is no standard shape for all viruses, so its shapes varies from virus to virus. We are coming to the morphology of plant viruses. So here understanding and knowing of morphology will be very very important to understand their chemical structure and the nature. So as I said earlier, that is a viruses come with a different shape, that is maybe rigid rods or flexuous rods or spherical or cylindrical rods, whereas normally the size ranges from 15 to 300 nanometer and the width of 480 to 2000 nanometer in length. So now we are here seeing here the morphology. Every virus, every plant virus is contains two major components, that is a nucleic acid and protein coat. So the first one is the nucleic acid. So the nucleic acid composition ranges from all viruses. So 5 to 40% of nucleic acid contains, except TMB, whereas the TMB contains 5% of nucleic acid. So all viruses contains two components, that is nucleic acid and protein coat. So the nucleic acid ranges from all viruses, that is 5 to 40%. Almost all plant pathogenic viruses contains 5 to 40% of nucleic acid, except TMB, whereas TMB contains 5% of nucleic acid. So here the nucleic acid may be RNA or DNA, but not both. As I said earlier, it contains only one type of nucleic acid, that is we can see here the nucleic acid packed inside the thread like or a local structure, that is nucleic acid. Here nucleic acid plays a major role in a disease spread and transmission. It plays a major role. Now coming to the second one, protein coat. So the composition of a protein coat of all viruses ranges from 60 to 95%, except TMB, that is 95%. So TMB contains 95% of protein coat. Why I am accepting the TMB here? TMB has a great economical importance as well as a model organism. That's why we are separating it from other viruses. So almost all plant viruses contains 5 to 40% of nucleic acid and 60 to 95% of protein coat. Here the protein coat of a virus is called capsid, which means it is a structural subunit of capsids. Are called capsome. Here we can see here. These all structures, these all, you know, bonding like structures are capsid. A single subunit is called capsomere. A single unit is called capsomere. Here this protein coat only protect the nucleic acid. It has no role in disease spread or transmission. You can see here, this is the nucleic acid. It protect these all things which is outside. It's a protein coat. Protein coat only protect the nucleic acid and has no role of disease spread or transmission. Nucleic acid plays a major role in disease spread or transmission. Now we will see what are all the components. Have seen nucleic acid contains a nucleic acid capsid. The membrane, that outer membrane is a capsid, enveloped proteins, that is used to bind the cells, attached to the binding cells. The spikes protein, the holds on cells, and the nucleocapsid is a combination of nucleic acid and protein coat. Protein coat is capsid, that is called a nucleocapsid. I told you F.C. Bowden and N.W. Pyrie called as a virus is a nucleoprotein, because it is a combination of nucleic acid and the protein coat. That's why it's called as a nucleoprotein. Now we'll see a few of the definitions. That is capsid. Capsid, in the sense, it's a protein coat or shell that envelops viral genome. Protein coat or shell that envelops viral genome. Simply a protein coat. Very simple. Simply protein coat, that is called capsid. Capsomere is a single subunit. A single subunit is called capsomere. The all subunit are combined to form capsid or protein coat. Whereas a single subunit is called capsomere. We can see here capsomere. Capsid, all the subunits of capsid. Capsomere means a single subunit. This single subunit is called capsomere. So virion means the matured virus particle. If after entering into the plant cells, the viral particles get matured, the matured virus particles are called virions. Protein subunits. So the virus encodes a protein molecule that makes capsomeres or nucleoproteins, which are also known as the structural subunits. So these are all the different types of components on the, though this is nucleic acid, capsid or protein coat. Each single unit is called capsomere. These are the spikes which is used to bind the plant cells or adhere the plant cells. This is cell envelope. But the two major things that we have to consider is nucleic acid and protein coat. Now coming to the tobacco mosaic virus, as I told you, it has a great economical importance as well as a historical importance. So for study of each and every virus, TM is considered as a model organism. That's why we are discussing about tobacco mosaic virus. We'll see a few of the characters what tobacco mosaic virus having. So the TMV belongs to the genus Tobamovirus, which is a submicroscopic rigid rod shaped, which is a rod shaped. You can see here on the microscope, rod shaped structure can be seen. Here, rod shaped structure can be rigid rod shaped. Is a rigid rod shaped. It produces mosaic like symptoms. Mosaic means yellowing. As I told you earlier, whatever the symptom it is, whatever the viral symptom it is associated with yellowing. Yellowing is must and should. After that, we can see the other types of symptoms that is produced by viral pathogens. So, in a recent ICTV classification, that is the International Committee on Taxonomy of Virus, the Tobamovirus comes under the family Virgaviridae. In recent classification, it comes under the family Virgaviridae. So, TMV is a positive single-stranded RNA, which comprises of 5% nucleic acid and 95% of protein. So very, very important. All plant viruses contains 5 to 40% of nucleic acid and 60 to 95% of protein. There is an exemption, that is TMV. Of course, few of the other viruses also exempted, but the most important virus that we have to look into in plant viral is tobacco mosaic virus. So that's why we are discussing about tobacco mosaic virus in detail. So yeah, tobacco mosaic virus contains 5% of nucleic acid and 95% of protein coat. And the TMV contains 158 amino acids. It is a very, very important, and there is a chance to ask in different types of exams. So TMV contains 158 amino acids and 2130 capsomere subunits and 6400 nucleotides. It's a very important, 158 amino acids, 2130 capsomere subunits or coat protein subunits, and then 6400 nucleotides. So the molecular weight of TMV is 17,600 daltons or 17.6 kDa, and it is a rigid rod shaped virus, and it measures about 300 into 18 nanometer in diameter. 300 in the sense 300 length, the length is 300 nanometer and the breadth is 18 nanometer in diameter. The length is 300 and the breadth is 18 nanometer in diameter. We can see here this red color structure is a nucleic acid. Red color structure is a nucleic acid, whereas this structure or this pink color, or you know, this structure is protein molecules or protein coat. So the thermal inactivation point or the temperature that can kill the TMV is at the rate of 93 degrees centigrade.